get some information on them, see where they played last year, check their stats, see where they're playing next year, or if there's availability on these players. So super excited for this. Stay tuned. We'll be doing some live feed, and I'll be doing some color commentating throughout the game. Gregor Pauser here coming in. This is something that he does tremendously. He's a big body guy. He can really yield. I like about him. He's got very good lateral mobility. And once he gets over that blue line, he really does a great job of finding ways to attack the net. Gregor's got great range, great speed for a big man. When I think if you watch him out through the course of the night, the small little tangible things, I like that he does. It's a lot like a pro game. So great play by Gregor Pauser there. And here we have it. The kids are feeling each other out, making a few, some of summertime errors, but I think the game's going to get more and more competitive as we go on here, start getting some chemistry, start seeing some more offense. Bobby Metz wheeling and dealing. Really smart player. I like the way he sees the ice, controls the play. Very calm, very poised. And a lot of that has to do with how good his footwork is in small areas. Knows how to escape, knows how to shimmy, and draw defenders out of coverage. You got Ty Bash out too. I like the way he is. Very tenacious. Keep an eye on him tonight. Very strong. He's almost like a pit bull when he's out there. Super competitive. Great skater. And again, I like the way he attacks the net, makes plays. He had that nice sauce pass to Chad Pinchek there a couple minutes ago. That's two stick picks right there for Tarek Mladenovic. Very active stick, and that's something really I find that the Swedes do a very good job of teaching in the youth and also in the pro when I got a chance to play pro there. Very active sticks, using that thing as a weapon, just extending your range, angling guys, and having an active stick. Tarek's really good at that. I love the way that he is aggressive on guys and aggressive on defense, again, with his angling, and then he's very active with that stick. Super smart player. There's Tarek Mladenovic. Here he is again. The great poke check, great active stick. Gets over that line, tries to take advantage of a bad gap. Great shot off the screen there. Great job by Tarek. And we're going to go over this in video tomorrow. Show that D. That's where you got to gap up and take that guy's space away, because that's a real threat when the forward can get a shot off from there. Shooting through a screen. Sometimes the release gets hidden. Makes it very tough for the goaltender. So as D, you want to gap up there. Make sure you're not giving that guy that time and space. Oskar Gridas coming down here. Oskar was the MVP of the Riga Cup this year up in Latvia. Very strong defenseman, good development. I've been skating with him for about a month and a half, almost 2 months. The progress has been amazing. Again, winning that award of best defense with the Riga Cup is a pretty a big accomplishment and something I know he's really proud of and put a lot of work into. He plays up in Riga for HS Riga in the Jahal and the Optibet, the OHL Latvian Hockey League. So keep an eye on Oscar tonight. Michael Bashoff standing pipe, strong in the pipes here. Great save. The RVH is down, took away a lot of time and space. Guy shooter didn't have much to look at there. You know, this happens fast, quick turnover, boom, he's in place. Great athleticism from Michael Bashaw on that save. Didn't give the shooter much at all. We got Alex Simonovic in on the forecheck. D-man working the corners. Refs letting them play. No penalty on the call there. Letting the boys play, letting it go. Got to get some flow into this game. Yeah. Grega. Great goal here by Urban Padrega. Great play, good patience here, and this is something I preach a lot to about players, is changing the angle, messing with that defending forward. I love what he does here. Comes in, pump fakes, moves laterally by one and a half steps right here. Fake, boom, defender's out of the way. Clear shot. I mean, it's a nice bounce off the defenseman, but what a great play by Padrega there. Very patient with the puck. That's a good player. Smart, using the defending player's mistakes to gain a better advantage on an attack towards the net. So great play by number 98 there. And he's going to be playing next year for Olymp in the men's league. So taking a step up, playing with the big boys next year. I've got a chance to see him over the course of the season. And again, his development's been great. Strong skater, very good puck moving defenseman, strong on his feet, and he's built like a brick. So keep an eye on number 98 on Black. Grega. Ne. And net for the red team, we got Michael Bashaw. Michael played in the NAHL last year. Great goaltender, very active in the net. Unfortunately, he had a bit of an injury last year, battled back, took him a couple months to recover, and he just got cleared about a month and a half ago. So it's been a pleasure to see him battle back, and he's in pretty good form tonight. You can see in this period, he's playing very well, very active, tracking the puck very well. And then on the black team, we got Ian Sotler in net. Last year, Ian was in Finland playing U19. Again, he's another very quick, very active goaltender. I like the way he is with his technique, the way he competes. These are two really good goaltenders. They're going to be our goaltenders for the first period, and we're going to make a switch after this period. For the second period, we're going to change up the goaltenders, and I'll introduce those players after the first intermission. This is good. We got our power play. We're going to have a video session tomorrow. We're going to be going over all this stuff. Power play, penalty kills, offensive strategies. It's all part of the camp. This is the unique part of this combine camp. The players playing these games, we get to record them, have them on the live stream first. Then we record them. We go the next day and we break it down and give these players some, right away fixes, some kind of development right on the fly. That's the exciting part about this camp. Makes it a little bit unique. Again, getting the chance for some exposure, people to see them play, but also learn throughout the course of the week in a five-day event. They'll get 11 ice practices in these three games. So we'll get a lot of development in this week. And watch after watching that last power play, we're going to have a session tomorrow for sure on setups and how to attack on the PP. Bobby Metz, nice try there. Nice block by Metz. Very active, the smart kid, sees the ice very well. Mark Pivac played last year in Michigan. Mark is playing for St. Mary's Varsity out in Michigan, looking for a place to play next year. NCDC, NAHL, put some interest there. He'd like to go back to the States. He'd like to continue his career at the NCAA. Pulling for Mark, we're going to get him some development this week. Try to look for the best spot possible for him next year. Yeah. Your mic's on. Hey. Live? Okay, standing here with me, got Tarek Mahmutovic. Tarek played last year in Sweden. Tarek, we can hear you on your mic. How are you feeling about the game? How's it going so far?
I feel good. I think we're more dominant than them, so I think if we keep pressuring them, they will make mistakes as they do, so I think that will be a huge if we just keep pushing hard.
Okay. How was your season last year in Sweden? What was it like?
It was great. Unfortunately, we didn't have as good team as we hoped to. But individually, I developed a lot. But I think team-wise, we were like at the start of the season, we weren't at the highest level. But at the end of the season, we got some injured players back. And it was a great journey so far. So. And I enjoyed every time with the team because it was good team spirit there.
That's good, yeah. Next year you're going to Rogla. How do you feel about that? You excited?
Yeah, it's exciting. It's one of the best clubs in the Europe, if not the world. So I'm pretty excited about that.
That's awesome. Well, great first period. I saw you good active stick a couple times. Pokecheck made some great scoring chances. See you finish some off. Everybody wants to see you dangle. I talked you up pregame.
Yeah.
We're looking for some show here, buddy. Yeah. Let's see some snipes.
Okay.
Keep it going. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
Let me get your mic.
Yeah.
Good job, bud. We're live. Bobby Metz, how you doing, buddy?
I'm great. How are you?
How's the camp going so far?
So far, it's really good. I'm really happy I'm here. Obviously, a great time to meet you and train with you and advance my game. So I'm really excited about it.
Well, we're excited to have you here. How was your season last year? Tell everybody where you're playing.
So I played at the Minnesota Wilderness in the North American League. I finished my last league of junior, and then I'm going to Colgate University. It was a good year for me. Definitely took some strides, and now I'm ready for college. So
that's
definitely
awesome.
A good year.
Yeah, that's great. We're excited to see where you go next year and how the season goes. What do you think so far? It's only one period. We had testing today. We didn't have so much hockey, but from that first period, what do you think about, you know, playing a little bit European style? What was it like for you that first period?
European style, it took me a second to kind of get used to it because guys go where I never thought they would go. But it's definitely a good exercise. Like, I think I'm tracking guys well. They kind of got a lucky goal. And I think as a team, we're playing well. We just need to convert. So a little tired, obviously, third skate of the day, but we'll be good. We'll be there.
That's why I want some adversity for you guys. Make you back.
It's here for sure.
I saw you jumping in there, made a couple nice plays. Keep going. We'll find the back of the net tomorrow. We'll work on the shooting, get you finished those off.
Yeah,
okay?
Yeah. I'll score next game at least if it's not tonight.
So. All right, buddy. Thanks a lot, Bobby. Good job. Keep it going. Yeah. Oh. Okay. We're going to go to a quick break here. They're going to clean the ice. We'll be back in around 10 minutes. Stay tuned. He had that nice sass pass, sauce pass to Chad Pinchak there a couple minutes ago. That's two stick picks right there for Tarik Mumadovic. Very active stick, and that's something really I find that the Swedes do a very good job. Down here, Oscars was the MVP of the Riga Cup this year up in Latvia. Yeah. Grega! Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Again, he's another very quick, very active goaltender. I like the way he is with his technique, the way he competes. These are two really good goaltenders. They're going to be our goaltenders for the first period. And we're he's a smart kid, sees the ice very well. All right, welcome back, everybody, for period two. We got a goalie change coming up here. Omar Jarovic, and he'll be going in for the black team, and Vid Kranjek will be coming in for the red team. So we're looking for a little more excitement here in the second period. I think the guys were just trying to figure each other out, get a chance to give them a little pump-up talk in between periods. I think we're going to see a little more enthusiasm here coming in the second period. But this goalie change, I'm excited to see these two goaltenders go at it. Very good. We had a goaltender coach, Luka Grachner, has been working with these kids. He was here last year for the original camp, and now we're here for the combine camp, year number one of the combine camp. Luka's back. Luka's still an active player. He actually had a hell of a season last year in the DEL2. He had one of those kind of almost like a miracle performance as a goaltender. Single-handedly got them into playoffs, and he was on a nightly basis getting standing ovations. That's not easy to do as a goaltender. And now we got that resource here for our goaltenders at this camp. Luka Grachner is teaching these kids. He's really good with them one-on-one, in depth, articulates the information very well. So we're pumped to have him here and have him be a resource for the kids. Come on through. Attaboy. Good period, buddy. Ian Sotler with a great first game. Good first appearance. And I'll get Luka will get a chance to work with him tomorrow. Getting ready here for puck drop. Period number two on its way. Ty Bashoff
Here we go, buddy. Let's see if he wins this draw. We're going to get him a little bit lower tomorrow. We're going to work on our draws. Yep. And we're off. Come on, Bobby boy. Oh, what a play, Bobby. Grega. What a play by Bobby Metz there. Great read jumping in. Hell of a play. As I told you, I love this kid's vision. Great back check there by Canobla. Bobby jumps in, sees the ice, head up. Look at this play. Finds the guy, gives him a wide open face of the net. We talk about this often. Find the threatening face of the net. What you can do as a player. A lot of players will walk in here and just try to rip it through traffic. I like Bobby gets his head up. Great peripheral vision. Boom. What a play. Great pass. Great finish off there. Love to see it. Love to see it. Greg Deposito in front of the net there. Like we talked about pre-show. He's always around there. Causing havoc. Reminds me a little bit of how Corey Perry plays. Being there. Being a pest in front of the net. And again, Greg is 6'4", 215. You're not moving him too easy. Got a 1-1 hockey game here. So, see what happens. But if it comes down to it, we're going straight into a shootout. We don't do overtime here in Bled, Slovenia at the Rob Shrimp Combine Camps. We go right into the shootouts, as that was where I was kind of slotted in at the end of my NHL career as a penalty or, shootout specialist. So, we'll see what these kids got. Arwin Nylander strikes the post. Opportunistic, jumps on there. Way to be there, Arwin. There we go, projector. Wind it up. This kid's got wheels. Oh! You see Gregor pause, trying to spring for a breakaway there. Great eyes on the ref to catch that. He called that offsides from the goal line. This guy's got unbelievable. He's like eyes of a hawk. These referees are no joke. Former professional players. Happy to have them here to make these games more official. So it's good for the players to have the rules set like a proper game, so this isn't just a summertime scrimmage. I told these players this is live hockey, live action. People are paying attention to these games and looking, scouting, and seeing if they would fit on their roster. So it's good to have legitimate refs and the whole situation be, you know, legit, not just pond hockey. Oh, good read by Bobby Metz. Way to hold that. That was a 2-on-0 the other way. Got a little ping pong going on here, back and forth. Boys are still trying to feel themselves out here, trying to get a flow for it. Oh, Bobby Metz. What a save by Omar. Way to hold tight there. It's good compete. I like the way he plays. He's always active. He stays in the fight. Very competitive goaltender. See, this was great battle. Got back to the post. Takes away that wraparound from Bobby Metz and then follows up with a save on Posler. That's a great, great example of his competitiveness. Omar's awesome. He's one of those goalies when you're practicing with him. He'll take a million shots and never complain. I was out with a few players with him a couple times on a couple occasions, and I had to have a pep talk with the shooters because they hit him in the head, in the groin area, 10 times at least, and he didn't say a peep about it. I had to call a TV timeout and give the shooters a little pep talk about respecting the goalie, not shooting at their head or groin area, for that matter. If you're shooting at those two areas, that means you missed by a mile, so you want to tighten up the scopes a little bit. And the other thing is, when you as shooters, if you get a goalie to come out there and you start beaming him in the head, you got to start to ask yourself, how many times is this guy going to want to come out for me for practice? Tristan Canova, nice play. I just like his range. Big right-handed shot. Again, he's really grown into his body. He's really smooth, silky. And when you get a chance to see him get the shots off, his release is unbelievable. Hides it really well, snaps it really well. So I talk a lot about as a shooting coach, pop on the shot, and Tristan's got that ability. And it's great to see. Martin's Chetopinchuk here on a breakaway. Oh, what a goal. There we go. Kiddo. I told you, I talked about him in the pre-show. It looks like he's worked on his celebrations as well. But the breakaway, what a move. Held that puck in a shooting position all the way. Made the goalie respect it. Had the respect. Made his fake. Got it to the backhand. Got it up quick. That's something really important for players. Come down on breakaways. Getting that puck in a shooting position. Right here, you see shot. Pulls it. Now, when he pulls it from his forehand to his backhand, that changes about, you know, in European language, 3 meters. In North American language, it's about 10 feet, and that's a very tough save for the goaltender. So that's what you're trying to achieve on that breakaway as a player. And Martin did a great job executing there. Ooh. Oh, he shoots it after the whistle. Nobody went after. Boy, did you get a slash in shin pads there? Someone did let him know. This is Ty Bashoff to a T, though. He's always attacking, trying to attack the middle ice. Very good on his edges, shifty player, and he's like a bull in a china shop. I really like the way Ty plays, his aggressiveness, his compete. He's a super competitive kid, cares a lot, and he's hardworking, great kid. So happy to see him here. We're going to see how he does through the course of the week and how he develops, and keep an eye on him. Next year he's playing for the Honey Baked Ham, and that's a great organization. So I think he's going to get, you know, a lot of good resources there for his development and grow as a player. And eventually I see him being a really good player in the USHL. Bobby Metz joining the rush. Can't talk about this kid enough. He's super smart. Sees the ice very well. There he is again, number 7. Dictating the play, offensive. Then he kills my vibe. Turnover on the toe drag in the middle, but that's okay. I like the way he jumped in the play there. His aggressiveness, and, you know, jumping in, being a second wave of offense, sometimes the first wave of offense with his skating ability, the way he sees the ice, he can move really well, jumps in those holes. Tion Lobre, he's throwing the body. He's a built kid, too. You got to see this kid also. They're all the same kind of speech. They're all very competitive kids. But when he gets going, man, he's the type of kid that can go out in one shift, throw 3 or 4 body checks that are crunching, and it's momentum swinging. And it's his ability to do that on top of the way he shoots the puck. He can finish off really well. He's got a hell of a shot, hell of a release. So that ability to be physical but also have that scoring touch is what makes him a special player. And I've seen him one time come down on a breakaway. He got tripped, went headfirst into the boards, didn't even flinch, came out back the next shift, and he scored a goal. So most kids running in the wall like that would have shut it down for at least a couple minutes, but Tion gets right back up, and you can't stop this kid. And here he comes down the wall with the puck. See what he's got. That's a turnover at the blue. He'll be on video tomorrow. Oh! That's what they call a snowplow. that's a penalty, but it's effective because, you know, once you come down like that in a snowplow, where's the guy going to go if he doesn't flip it over you? There's nowhere you can go with the puck. So effective, but it is against the rules. You're not allowed to snowplow guys' feet, so we'll have him on video tomorrow to go over that. Simonovic laying the body there, separating the man from the puck. Effective. We got to get rid of it. You're on the PK, you got to get that down. This is what happens. Now you're going to get sustained zone pressure. You get a chance to ice it, you got to get it out. Here we go. We get a chance to watch Tarek work the wall. He's a very good half wall player. Again, sees the ice very well. I like the way that how Tarek puts the pace on passes here. When he makes the passes, he makes the right passes, and he puts the right amount of pace on it as well. The receiving player can do what they want with it. That's important as a half wall player, you know, making the right plays and also not whipping, you know, 100 mile an hour passes at people. You don't always have to whip the puck. Taking a little off when you can is the proper way to do that. And a great example, that would be a guy that's been doing it for a long time, Swedish player, Nicholas Backstrom. Watch how he dishes the puck. He's a great guy to learn from. Red looked like they were electing to go down two men there, not putting a player on the ice. Keep an eye on Arwen Nylander. We're working really hard on faceoffs together. She was around a 10-15% faceoff person, and we started working on technique and strength on the draws, and she's actually been really good on them, dominating, using her forearm strength, using technique, just changing a couple things. Usually with young centermen, that's something you got to talk about, is technique and how to use their strength, use their core, use their forearm strength to their advantage. A lot of players try to use all skill and timing, but that's tough when you start getting it up in the leagues. Players get stronger. See guys like a Jay Beagle that's made a career out of it. A guy I played with in Long Island, Zdeněk Knopka, made a career out of it. He used around a 65-70% face-off guy. Take draws, win them, and then get off. So, you know, it's definitely something really important in the game, and it's really important for puck possession. As a young centerman, understanding that's a big part of the game when you start talking about time with the puck, offensive zone time, instead of chasing the puck. Here we go, pause. They're winding it up. Try to pinch check with good play, get his head up. Come on, Tarek, let's see it, kid. Game notes. Oh, like that lateral movement there by Tadek Mamutovic. Great play, man. Get lateral there. You get sideways. It makes it really tough on the D's gap. It also makes the goaltender move, makes the goaltender work. And again, I talk about this a lot in my teachings, changing the face of the net. So as he's doing that, moving lateral, the goalie has to work. Face of the net is continuously changing, and that gives that shooter a lot higher percentage of scoring. Getting that goalie in movement, never letting him get set. And you can see Ty Bashop comes and does the same exact thing. What a goal. Great shot by Ty. Tarek set the ground for him there. Did it the first time, and Ty Bashaw follows it up, does the same exact play, and this is exactly what I was talking about. Watch from this behind the net view, watch how hard the goalie has to work to get set to the shooter. He's here, starts moving lateral, shuffle, never gets square, and that shot's already on its way. He can't protect the face of the net. So brilliant move by Ty Bashaw there, really understanding how to attack the goalie. That great execution, great accuracy on the shot, everything. Great shot there. Here we go. 3-1 here. Looks like shootout's not looking so good. Looks like we're going to get a clear-cut winner. At the end of the camp, the winning team, we got three games, so the best out of three, the players will be getting a Bauer stick. Every player will get a new Bauer stick. Thank you to Bauer for being a partner and donating that for the kids. They're all excited about that. It gives them something to shoot for, get excited about. And, yeah, I'm excited to have that competitiveness for the kids. I wanted to make sure that they had something to shoot for, something to play for, not only just the scouts and people watching on the stream, but also get inside that locker room competitiveness, you know. Wanted a little more. Give them something, something to shoot for. We got Arwen back on the draws here, number 44, rocking my number. I think she's 3 for 4 tonight in the draws, so that's good. I'm proud of her. She's come a long way on those. Mark Pivac, nice play there. Good attack. Goal line drive. Here's Frisch. You see, once he gets moving, man, he's a bull. He can get moving. He's gotten really good shape off ice. He's put a lot of hard work in, a lot of dedication. He dropped about 15 pounds, and I can see in his speed and his explosive starts, and he's gotten a lot stronger. He was always strong, but now he's quick, which is, that's what's lethal. Those first couple strides. See, this is where I'm going to work with Ty tomorrow. His hands are too high. He's way too up high on his draws. Centerman, you got to get lower. Get over the draw. Get over the circle so that your leverage is over that puck. When you're standing straight up with your hands up like that, your hands are high, you're weak, and you're not able to use your core. It's very easy to break your wrist, and I don't mean that in the literal sense of breaking them in your bones, but I mean when you're taking a draw, if I'm trying to go against a guy and his hands are up high like that, I can break his strength easily. When you're down low, that leverage is low, and it's much harder to win that. That battle. Red's got to make a push here. Red's looking to make a push here. They're down by two. Down by two with eight to go. Let's see what the boys got here. My Pivac with the goal. The shot from the point. Tough play here. The goaltender comes out, tries to do the right thing, play the puck around the wall. Just tough break. But play to get it on net. Good things will happen when you get it on net. I think we got maybe got a deflection there by Julian Zimmerman. Good job getting to the net, stopping, being in position. Yeah, here he is. I think this gets deflected on the way to the net. It does, yeah. Tough one there. We got a 4-1 lead for Black here. Nice Tarek Mumatovic here. Really shifty player. Keep an eye on him. I like the way his edges work. He's put a lot of work into his skating, a lot of work into his edge work. Being a shifty player, he's very elusive, very good in the neutral zone attacks, making guys miss, not letting them get angles on him. And that eventually what that leads into is zone entries. And he gets a lot of time, he gets really good zone entries, and he gets what he wants out of the zone entry, not, you know, angle down the wall and tough areas. He gets to come in through the middle of the ice, which that's what you want as an offensive player. You gain control of the middle of the ice, you gain control of the D's gap and the D's footwork. Here's Urban Puntrecker. You can see how he has that patience up there, and that's something that's really that poise, that patience. It's huge, you know. It gives the other guys on the ice confidence, gives it predictability, makes a bigger window for opportunity. That's something like a Cal Makar has. What is the biggest, one of the biggest assets is patience up there at the blue line and not rushing things. So great play by Urban there, and I'd like, he's been good all night. He had the first goal where he made that shimmy, changed the angle on the shot, and you see him a couple times through the course of the game really have patience up there with that puck. There's no panic in his game, no panic when he has the puck. What we got here? We're going to get a... Oh. Refs are letting them play. I think we got a curfew on the game, so that's they're not about blowing any more whistles. We might run out of time. Alex Monovich coming in here, the big man. Look at the dangles. He's awesome. Great kid from Latvia, Riga, Latvia. Super, super good kid. Passionate about the game. His development's come a long way. We've worked a lot on his skating. I like it. He's going to grow into be a hell of a hockey player. He's put a little more weight on. I think that's the next step of the development for him. But I like his confidence level. I like the way he's not scared to try things. He's not scared to fail. Sometimes when he messes things up, he goes right back after it. You know what I mean? Doesn't get down, has a great attitude about it. So, yeah, great kid, great player. I think he's going to be an awesome player in a couple years. He just turned 16. He's a young buck, 6'4", 180 pounds. I think once he puts some meat on, puts some strength on, he's going to be really a hell of a hockey player. Great attitude. Really smart kid, too. Oh, what a play. Oh, wow. Nice play by Ty Bashoff there. See some guys on black here starting to get some chemistry. He's finding each other and getting into spots. Like this, Ty draws all that coverage to him, finds the open man. Goalie got there really good read by the goalie there. Gronchak made a really good read. That could have easily been a backdoor, wide open net. Tracks the puck well, makes the save. I think Mark Pivac was trying to block his teammate's shot. I don't know. I got to talk to him after the game. There's a difference between a net front screen and a blocking your teammate's shot. Latvia on Latvia here. Alex Zaparov coming down. Oh! Saved by Omar, flashing the leather. Look at that. Get the windmill going. That's confidence in his glove there. Hops back up, springing his step. Omar's glove's heating up here. Red's confidence level, I think, is going down. He's flashing the leather twice here in a row. Good job. Way to track that puck, Omar. Good net drive there by Julian Zimmerman. Inside, outside, use the body protection, get to the net. Not a bad play at all. Johannes Newman's been good on the draws tonight for Red. Let's see how he does against Bash here. Quick hands, jinxed him, totally jinxed him. That's a wicked jinx. I can't believe that one backfired real quick. Bashoff wins the draw right to where he set it up. He saw right before that draw, he actually lined his guy up there. I'd like to see that a lot. Centerman, it's very important to communicate with what you want out of the rest of your players because you're the one that controls the start of that play. If we rewind that back, you see Bashoff actually set him up directly where that puck went. And it's nice to see a play get finished off like that. It doesn't always go the way it planned as a centerman, but when it does, it feels really good. Great draw by Bash, great finish. I believe that was Oscar Oscar Bredis with the finish there. Good back pressure there by Martin Cherepinchuk. We talked about him pre-show, very responsible player. I see him being a great second, third line player, PK or shutdown guy. Again, makes really smart decisions with the puck. Great energy, he's a good skater for a big kid. Oh, Bobby Metz with the moves. Clipped out there 2 minutes in the second period. Alex Aparvoto is going to work on walking off the wall, attacking middle ice. Attacking the categories of the zone. I talk about it often. Get off the wall, get in the middle of the ice. We're going to have to start thinking about the player of the game. The player of the game tonight is going to be awarded with a Rocket Grip. Their company out of Latvia, Riga Latvia. They've been awesome. They gave the kids a bunch of grips to all use. But we're going to do a player of the game to get a special RS Camp customized grip. We'll be picking that after the game. So just want to give them a shout out. But again, great to us. They've got a great product. They're really good. I love it. They gave me some to sample when I was up in Riga. Great feel to it. And they're great kids out of Latvia. A couple young kids in college, university. Started their own company, and it's really taken off like wildfire. So if you get a chance, check out these guys, Rocket Grips, company out of Latvia. And now that I'm living in Latvia, looking to support local. Black takes a 1-0 series lead through the course of the week. Played a really good game in these kind of events. It's important to find chemistry early. I felt like Team Black in that second period really found their stride, found each other. And, they did a great job of coming together and making plays. Yeah, perfect. You're gonna hold this. Ty, how you doing, buddy?
Good, you?
How's your first couple days? Put that up.
Good. I love this camp. I mean, boys are great.
So the first couple days, how was the testing?
Good. The water bike killed, but yeah, everything else is good.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's good. We're happy to have you here. How was your season last year?
Great. I had almost 60 points in 30 games. I love the team. We played good.
That's good. You got a good group of guys there.
Yep.
Where were you last year? The Gamblers?
Yeah, Gamblers.
Tell everybody where you played last year.
Junior Gamblers.
Yeah. U16?
Yeah.
Nice. What did you have tonight? You had 2 points tonight?
Yeah. Goal and assist. Yeah.
What'd you feel about the big ice and the big surface?
I mean, I love it. There's a lot of room to dangle. I love it. It's fun. Yeah.
A lot more space.
Yeah.
Well, you're the player of the game for Team Black today. Good job. Keep it going. And we look forward to seeing you Wednesday night. Put the show on.
Thank you.
Thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
Come on over.
Here we got a special interview here. Hang on to this.
We got a mic. We're going to have to fix this. Special interview. We got brothers.
Yeah.
Ty and Michael Bashoff. Now we have, we just had Ty on. Now we got Michael. Michael, how was the first period? Well, you played only one period, but how was the start for you?
Tiring. Definitely not game conditioned yet, but.
We'll put this up.
I had a lot of fun. It was tough for us. The score doesn't really, show like how we played today. Definitely not a 5-1 game, but we did what we could. And what is it? Thursday is our next game.
Wednesday. We're coming back Wednesday. Yeah.
Coming back Wednesday. Red team, gotta represent. Gotta get a big win. So yeah.
That's good. Yeah, I was telling everybody, you know, you had a bit of an injury last year. You battled back. You got cleared about a month and a half ago. So it's good. I thought you played really well in that period, the period that you got in, and you looked active. You made a couple nice saves, a couple turnovers by your teammates, but you battled through. How'd you feel getting back in the game shape, and how'd that go?
I've just been training so hard, and, I mean, I think I'm game ready, like, just with everything. And it was tough getting back, but I'm starting to feel myself again. I'm starting to play the puck. Kind of starting to play how I normally play again, and it feels good. I'm having fun. That's all that matters.
Yeah, that's good. It's always tough. Injuries are tough, and they set you back, and mentally it's tough, and it's really important to get your confidence back, get back to how you feel good on the ice. So hopefully we can achieve that through the course of the week. I thought you played great tonight. Great job. I picked you as the star for Red, and I thought you played really well. So good job. We'll see you on Wednesday.
Thank you.
Good job, buddy. So thank you, everybody. Tuning in, what do we got here? Let's check out the stat line for tonight. We're going to check the players who performed well. Team Black really dominated. I thought they took over the game. So, yeah, we had Ty with 1-1. We've got a tie board here with for the points leaders. We've got Ty Bashoff, 2 points. Oscars Bridis, I told you, the Riga Cup, defenseman of the Riga Cup, showed up tonight. Martin Cheropinchik had a good night. Tadek Mutovic with 2 apples. The shots were 25-20 for Black's favor. So we're going to take these stats. We're going to look at them. We're going to go over them tomorrow as a group. We're going to do video sessions, and we're going to have these boys ready for Wednesday night, put on another show. So hope to see you guys tune in on Wednesday. see these great players in action. And, you know, scouts out there, take a look into these players through their Elite Prospects accounts. Check out their testing results. Check out their stats from last year. And that also through these accounts, you'll be able to get into contact. You have all their information, whether if they have representatives or not, or if you want to direct contact to the parents, that's the option. And we look forward to seeing you Wednesday night. Thanks for tuning in.
Time to hydrate.